Welcome to the Angular Timeline Component tutorial. Using the Syncfusion Angular Timeline Component, you can display a list of information in a sequential manner, visually representing a series of events that can be used in applications like order tracking and more. In this video, I will show you how to create an Angular application and add Angular Timeline Component to it. Additionally, you will learn how to align and disable the timeline items, change the orientation, and reverse the timeline. Before we get started, make sure you have installed the latest version of Node.js. I'll be creating the application using the Angular CLI tool. I will edit my code using Visual Studio Code and showing the output in the Chrome browser. Let's start with the application creation process. I open Visual Studio Code and install the Angular CLI using the command npm install -g /angular/CLI. Next, I will create a new Angular project. I use the command ng new project name and name my project my Angular app. Now I am going to create a project with an option to add a CSS style sheet. I choose the CSS option. The project creation has started, and an Angular project with dependencies is created. Now let me navigate to the project folder. To add the Syncfusion Angular Timeline component, I install the Syncfusion Angular Layouts package using the command npm install /ej2angularlayouts --save. The application is now ready to use. The first thing I must do here is register the trial license key to use Syncfusion components. I open the main TS file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To learn how to generate this license key, refer to the link in the description below. The application is now configured to use Syncfusion components. To apply styles to the timeline component, I navigate to the styles CSS file and add necessary CSS references by importing the material theme. Next, I open the app component TS and import timeline module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Layouts package. And register it within the imports array of the component section. To add items to the timeline component, I open app component HTML file and remove the default code. Then add a division element, and within it, let me include a JS timeline tag. Now I am going to display the order status of the product in the timeline. So open the app component TS file. Create an array called order status of type timeline item model and assign objects to it with a content field. To access this model class, let me import it from the Syncfusion Angular Layouts package. Now I need to include these items in the timeline component. Let me start by adding the items tag, which can hold multiple timeline item definitions. Inside this tag, I will add the item tag with the ng4 directive to create each item dynamically. This directive will loop through the order status array defined in the content property and set the content for each item accordingly. To use this directive, let me import the common module from the Angular package. After that, I add a class to the division element to align the element. Then, inside the style CSS file, let me implement the same class and set the height to 350 pixels and width to 520 pixels, along with a suitable margin. With this code changes, let me save the file and run the project using the command ng serve. Look here, the timeline component is displayed with order status and the provided content. If you want to display additional information on the opposite side, you can use the opposite content property. To demonstrate, I add the opposite content property and set appropriate values for each item. Here, I have set the date time on the opposite side of the content. Similarly, I will bind the opposite content property to item opposite content. In the timeline component, each item's time is shown on the opposite side of its content. Next, I am going to customize the appearance of the timeline items using the CSS class property. To display the success status in the first two items, I set the dot and connector CSS property to state success and completed. Here, state success and completed are custom classes that adds necessary styles to display the completion status. Likewise, I will add CSS properties for next two items. Similarly, I add a CSS class property with the custom classes .color and custom connector in the component tag. Next, I will bind the CSS class property to item.css class. Let me define the styles for the dot and connector classes. The first and second items display the completion status, and the third item displays the progress status. By default, the timeline component is rendered vertically. To change this, I set the orientation property with the value horizontal. You can also set it to vertical if needed. As you can see, the timeline component is now rendered horizontally. Like orientation, you can use align property to align the content in the timeline component. By default, the align property is set to after. But it can be changed to before, alternate, and alternate reverse. Now I am going to display the content with alternate alignment. So I add the align property and set the value to alternate. I also change the orientation property to revert the timeline to vertical position for demonstration. Checking now, the content is displayed in the alternate order. To reverse the order of the timeline, I can set the reverse property to true. Now the timeline is rendered in the reverse order. If I want to disable the items that are not reached in the timeline yet, I can enable the disabled property and set the item content property to disable true. Finally, I bind the disabled property to the item.disabled in the item tag. Notice the out for delivery item is now disabled. Let's wrap up this video. I have shown you how to add a Syncfusion Angular Timeline component to an Angular application. I have also shown you how to align and disable the timeline items, change the orientation, and reverse the timeline. If you want to try out the example used in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link to learn how to obtain a free license key to use our Angular components through our community license, if you are eligible. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please like it and subscribe to our channel.